This presentation is not intended nor approved for use as a continuing education course for dental health professionals or a certification course for coronal polishing. In this slide presentation, we will look at the Coronal Polishing Armamentarium, its purpose, application, some details about the materials and equipment needed. We'll look at criteria for acceptable coronal polishing, chart entry, and some specific principles of polishing and working with adults and children, and any potential medical emergencies. So we have here a list, and the next slide has a list of the armamentarium, and I'm going to use a photograph to describe this armamentarium. First, we have the basic setup, and this should be familiar to all. The mirror used for retraction, the mouth mirror used for retraction, reflect light, and the ever popular indirect vision. The explorer should actually be used with great care by the auxiliary performing the polishing. In California, it's the RDA, or not used at all. We don't want to be probing pits and fissures or fractures on teeth. We have to use great care, and of course, the cotton forceps. We have a disclosing agent that we're going to use, not necessarily used in the real world, the clinical setting, but for coronal polishing classes and examination, we use a disclosing agent. Comes in liquid or tablets. This is liquid, and we will dispense it in a cup for each patient. We're going to use the paint-on technique with a cotton tip applicator and paint it on the surfaces of the teeth, the coronal portion of the teeth. We want to use a lubricant on the patient's lips to avoid any staining, because that is, in fact, the purpose of disclosing solution. It's a vegetable dye, and it's used to make plaque visible or stain plaque. You want to be very careful in handling the material, because it does stain. It can stain the skin. It can stain clothes. So you want to be very careful with it. Also, you want to make sure that your patient is not allergic to dyes. That would be a contraindication in using a disclosing agent, whether it's liquid or tablets. Next, we have the straight handpiece, which will be used with a disposable prophy angle. We have the rubber cup prophy angle and the bristle brush, or the brush prophy angle. And the straight handpiece will be cleaned, debrided, lubricated, and sterilized for each patient. The prophy angles are disposable, so we would just discard them in the trash. Next, we have a polishing agent, which this is a commercial polishing paste in a single dose cup, and this one happens to be a prophy paste that is fluoridated and flavored and gluten-free, and very typical of the type of abrasive that is used for coronal polishing. You could also use a plain flour of pumice in some cases where perhaps patients don't like the flavor or are opposed to fluoride. A plain pumice could be used. Polishing agents, also known as abrasives, do come in various grades or grits. So there's extra fine, fine, medium, and coarse. And the paste itself, the abrasive, would be chosen by the type of stain that you're removing. So a very heavy stain, you might want to use a medium or possibly a coarse. Usually a medium will suffice. And someone who has some plaque but no stain would use a fine pumice. In most offices, they do go with the, with the medium grade. Properties of the paste itself, because of the different grades, it actually has a particle size. And the Effectiveness of the abrasive is determined by the particle size and the amount of pressure applied to the tooth. And we will discuss the amount of pressure a little later on in the presentation. We also have some polishing aids. Now, in California, the DDS, the RDH, and the RDAEF are the one, the professionals that are allowed to use polishing agents such as rubber points for amalgam restorations. Or abrasive strips can be helpful for stains in the proximal areas of the teeth. Other armamentarium to maintain the field or the oral cavity, the air water syringe, which is disposable, saliva ejector, which is disposable, HVE tip, which is disposable. 2x2s always come in handy to keep a neat, tidy patient's mouth as well as the area. Let me go back here. This is a Prophy cup holder. This one happens to be a ring, and I find it very useful when polishing to hold the paste close by. There is a hand mirror for patient education. Patient bib. Now, we don't use bib clips anymore. If you are using bib clips, you want to clean these really well and sterilize them. Otherwise, a disposable bib attachment or tape is good. Safety glasses for the patient to prevent any accidental splash or splatter, and it's always nice to have Kleenex available. Also, we have floss, and floss would be used to remove plaque from the proximal areas of the teeth. So the general procedure is, it's always a good idea to review the medical and dental history. Even though in the dental office, the patient is usually coming to us, if you're in California, the RDA, having seen the hygienist or the DDS for scaling and for us to polish. But it's good to review the medical and dental history because if a patient had, say, an artificial prosthetic cardiac valve, then or prosthetic cardiac valve, they would need to be pre-medicated with an antibiotic before a procedure as a polish. Or if a patient was having a herpes outbreak, you probably want to reschedule them so as not to exacerbate the condition. You want to explain the procedure to the patient. I'm going to polish your teeth, removing stain and plaque. You want to determine the amount of plaque by applying a disclosing agent and noting it, doing a plaque chart, the type and amount. Is it light? Is it heavy? Medium for plaque and stain. You want to polish in an orderly sequence so that you don't miss any teeth. You want to floss, which can be helpful to remove stain proximally and remove any Prophy paste, but the focus is to remove stain. Maintain patient comfort and communication. Ask them how they're doing. Simply, are you doing okay? And they can say, If it's a no, you want to figure out what they might need. And you want to maintain the oral cavity by evacuating fluids, rinsing as needed, and that also assists in patient comfort. Maintain infection control standards, always, always, always. A criteria for an acceptable polishing, the general preparation, do you have all your armamentarium? The polishing technique itself, here we go. Appropriate application of paste on the tooth, and for my students, you want to follow what you have been practicing in the coronal polishing lab. You want to use a fulcrum, which is usually the ring finger or the pinky, on non-mobile teeth. A chin fulcrum is acceptable, but the preference is on non-mobile teeth. Handpiece is used at low speed, and you're going to apply the Prophy cup with a lifting, wiping motion away from the gingiva. And again, polish in an orderly sequence so you don't miss any teeth. We want to utilize the light into the oral cavity, use good vision, use the mouth mirror when necessary, use the mouth mirror or a finger to retract lips, cheeks, and tongue, maintain that working feel by clearing fluids, evacuating fluids, and rinsing when necessary, utilizing the Prophy brush for occlusal surfaces, proper flossing technique. For my students, it will be behind the patient's head so that you don't use excessive force on the patient's mouth or teeth. And you need to have plaque removal. So if you follow the techniques, you should have plaque removal from the teeth. Other principles would be specific techniques for adults and children. They're actually very much the same. Now, children, we'd use the tell, show, do, but some adults could benefit, and it would be a nice explanation to do tell, show, do. Also, children, we can use the modeling technique, where if they see other children participating and cooperating, they would be more comfortable, and always an award, a prize for being cooperative. Is actually nice for both adults and children. You want to make sure that you look at their health history, so if they have any pre-medication requirements, or to avoid any medical emergencies. So if a patient says they have asthma, you want to ask them, do they have their inhaler and have it available? If a patient were to experience syncope, my students and those of you watching this, you want to make sure you know what to do. Recline the patient in a supine position and get assistance. If they were hyperventilating, put the patient in an upright position, have them put their hands over their nose and mouth, calmly talk to them, and have them breathe slowly. And you want to be able to recognize such medical emergencies as well. So the basic life support certification is required by the Dental Board of California in order to participate in a coronal polishing course. A chart entry for, or also known as progress notes or clinical notes, would be the date, the name of the procedure, which would be coronal polishing. Include information on the stain. Is it light, medium, heavy? Do you know the name of the stain? If applicable, any special notes, such as the name. The amount of plaque, is it light, medium, or heavy? Your materials used, disclosing liquid, the type of Prophy paste, any adjunct aids. Did you give any oral hygiene instruction to the patient? How did the patient react to the procedure of coronal polishing? And in California, you need to write your initials and your designated number or your complete signature for performing the procedure. Other polishing devices that you may encounter. Now in California, according to the Dental Practice Act, only the dentist and the registered hygienist can use an air powder polisher. So these are devices that have a bicarbonate of bicarbonate soda in a powder form, and water is attached to the unit, and it sprays out sort of like an ultrasonic cleaner or scaler, but it sprays out the bicarbonate at a high volume, and it's very efficient at removing stain. And you may see this in an office, but again, in California, according to the Dental Practice Act, only the dentist and the hygienist can use an air powder polisher. This concludes the Armamentarium criteria for polishing, principles of polishing, and handling and preventing medical emergencies in the dental office, and specifically during coronal polishing. I thank you very much for watching and learning.